Hello and welcome to Sketch Together. On this video, we're gonna take a look at the newest addition to the craft plugin from InVision called Prototype. A prototype allows you to create rapid prototypes inside Sketch without leaving the app, just previewing on your phone. And not only that, but it also gives you access to native iOS components like the camera, the keyboard, and the web viewer. This is seriously a game changer, a plugin that will render a lot of mobile prototyping tools obsolete. Right now, at the time I'm recording this, Prototype is only available as a beta, so if you want to try it out, reach out to InVision and ask them for an access key. You might get lucky. Okay, enough talk. Let's get to it. Okay, so Prototype is part of the Craft plugin. Once you have it installed, it will appear here and you will be able to turn it on or turn it off. Right now I'm Prototype Beta and I'm able to use it. So it also appears here on my menu and I can start playing with it. So let's see the first thing that that you can do with it, which is adding links between screens. And you can create links between screens with any layer or any group, and you can also do it with just pressing C. So for example here, I'm going to add a link between this button and this screen. So just press C, and then I can start adding a link to that screen. And then I can start adding a gesture, or I can also say what is the behavior and the type of animation. So for this one, I'm going to say that it animates from the right. And I add the link, and that's it for adding links. Let's test it on my phone. And I have QuickTime Player, and so we can see this is currently my phone. And here I'm going to, I have the InVision Viewer app. And I'm going to open the prototype and have it here, and I tap on it on input fields, and then it opens the screen exactly how you would expect it to do. So now I'm going to add all the links to all the different screens, all the things that I want to show you. I'm going to press C. This one will link to this, add link. This one will link to this screen. All of them are going to be pushing. This one is going to be, from the right. And then you know what? This one, I'm going to edit, and instead of coming from the right, as you can see, I can edit those gestures here. I'm going to edit, and instead of coming from the right, I'm going to say that it's come from the bottom, just as the camera would do. I'm going to close this, and then I'm going to add another link to the fix headers button. I think I already did. One for this, see, and it takes me here from the right, whatever. And now I'm going to add a close button, so this one. The first thing also that I want to do is this one, to this link, I want it to add as to show as a modal. So, and when it shows as a modal, you have the ability to add a destructor, which is an overlay. So I'm going to say black, and the opacity 78% is good, and also a blurred background. And then when it animates out, it's going to be the opposite. Instead of coming from the bottom, it from the top to the bottom. I'm going to save it. And over here, I'm going to start adding links back. So for example, this guy, I'm going to press C, and then instead of linking to back to the screen, I'm going to say that it goes back as over here. Add the link, then this one, I'm going to select this, and I'm going to say that it closes. Perfect. This one is going to be a back button, so back, and then this one also a back button. Perfect. I added all my links between the screens, and now I can start testing it. I'm going to go here to QuickTime and to select the start screen, and this is my phone. I can start. I open this and I go back. I open this. This opens as a modal, and I close it. The fix header comes from the right. The web view, the screen comes from the right too, and I go back. Cool, I added all my links, and this was inside Sketch without leaving Sketch. This is a game changer, as I'm telling you. Now, this is one of the coolest things from this plugin, is that you can add input fields, and you can make any text layer an input field. And let's go ahead and try this. So I'm going to open this, and here there's a button that says input field. So this text layer I'm going to turn into an input field, and I have all these options. So I'm going to use email as a placeholder, and then also it allows me to say what type of input is it, and I'm going to say single line, which is since it's an email. No, actually, I'm going to select email address, and then by default the keypad is going to be the email keypad, and that's it. I think that's all I need. And also for this one, I'm going to say an input field too, but this one is going to be a password. And automatically adds the keypad this simple text. And the placeholder is password. I'm going to say save, and let's preview it. So I'm going to open. As you can see here, it's different from the design, where it looks like a placeholder already is gray. So I'm going to press on it, and automatically gives me the keyboard, and I can start typing and add, and I can put my keyboard, my email. As you can see, it cuts here, and that's because I, over here, all my design, I made it small. So I'm going to make it grow it a little bit. The same with this guy. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, and let's test it out. So I press again, and I can start typing, and now it gives me all that space. I'm going to select the password. Sorry. And it acts as a password, as it hides every input that I put, which is pretty cool. Having access to the iOS native keyboards is amazing. So now let's test the camera. Yes, I'm going to be able to test the camera. So this guy, I'm going to add a link to it. And this link is going to be to the camera here, as you can see. And I'm going to add a link, and by default, I'm going to say, yeah, rear. And then I'm going to add that link. And also here, I want that photo that I took, whatever photo I take, I want it to be displayed in this thing. So to do that, I don't know if it's going to be easier to do later, but right now you do it by making that layer called photo. So I'm going to try it out. Let me open here QuickTime so you can see what I'm doing. Here, I'm going to press the take pic button. And as you can see, now I access the camera. And I'm going to do a selfie mode. Hello. That looks horrible. Let's retake that photo. There you go. I'm going to use that photo and then automatically put it on my design too. Now, also, sometimes you want to have, everything is scrollable on every prototype, but sometimes you want to say some of the header, a header to make it fixed, or a footer. So I'm going to select this. And I'm going to go to prototype, and I'm going to say this is a fixed header. So it will always be fixed to the top. And then this button is going to be a fixed footer. And now let's test it. Let me open QuickTime so you can see what's going on. I open my prototype. And now everything is scrollable except for the parts that I said that were fixed, which is pretty fucking cool. Okay, so now I'm going to show you also web view. Yeah, you can also access any website. So for example, this one, I'm going to say, I'm going to make it a web view, this layer. I'm going to go to HTTP, and let's see if it opens the sketch together. Sketchtogether.io. Scroll enable, hopefully it's mobile friendly and safe. And let's preview it. And let me open my web viewer. Yep, as you can see here, I have access to see all of my website, sketchtogether.io, inside my prototype. I go back. Oops, apparently I have to open it. And then there you go. Damn, it even loads the animations. Well, it's just a web viewer, so it's like accessing Safari from your prototype, which is freaking amazing. And that's it. Those are the main things that you can do with Craft 2.0. Let me show you again. So you can add links, then you can add inputs and make anything an input field, any text layer, and even access different keypads, which is freaking cool. And add backlink back, and then access a camera. I'm going to take another selfie. That's horrible. You can exit it. You can also say that some of them are going to be fixed headers or fixed footers. And also you can add web view. As you can see here, I have a website open. It's my website. Go check it out. It's pretty cool. And that's it. That's horribly, horribly awesome. And I, whenever it's available for everyone, I will ask you to check it out because this is, again, a game changer.